introduction.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Adetifa.
Okay. Can we know? Don't say anything. Can we know about your educational background?
Okay, so I studied music up in Akins. I started my secondary school. I attended Queen's College, and when the admission was not first coming, I felt like somebody told me about music. And although before then, maybe when I was in my SS2, I was taking this music class. It was organized by a particular church, but it's not a particular church. Like you can all churches come together, but I just come. They teach us theory, teach us practical, and so that was how I got singing. My SS2, we go for it every Tuesday, and still now I still ask myself, like, how did I go for them? Because I have to go to school on Wednesday, but I still go for it. And so after my secondary school, the admission was not forthcoming. My dad wanted me to be a banker. I wanted to be a banker, so anyways. So someone told me about Peter Kings, and I said, wow, that's a nice opportunity. I had a problem with convincing my dad, but you know, mom's thing. So at the end of the day, I got to Peter King. It was 2 years, and I took exams at Muson, put in the Muson Center. But then I still had to go back to my banking and finance in school. So I did that at Legacy of Banking University. The thing is, when was the first time I took it, I held in my microphone. I can't remember my sleep because, you know, while we were young, we were always in the choir. So let me take it from the point where I knew I could sing.
Okay.
So let me say when I was in Peter King, because then I knew I was always singing in church. But when I got to school, I didn't have all the confidence because there were people that could sing. So I was always like, let me not sing here where there are good singers. But there was a particular day like that in my room, and I was just singing this song. And you know, they all gathered, we had girls still, fine. So all the girls were outside and I just heard them clapping like, what? Hey, so you can sing. You know, that was when I knew I could sing, because I felt like we're here to learn a new thing, and they are there before me. And if you're saying I can sing, then definitely I can sing. That was when I knew I could sing.
I know. I believe you've been to the recording studio before.
Yeah, sure.
Have you ever recorded any?
I've recorded quite a number of songs. I've recorded with Tony Allen, the popular Tony Allen. And I can't remember the first time I was in the studio.
Okay.
So I've recorded Omo. Omo is a song. Omo is called Omo, promoting the African child. It's for this organization this foundation I'm trying to put together. And that was it. And several other songs like that.
Okay, your first outing to play in public, how do you handle tension?
The tension. My first outing, my major first outing
major
with my guitar.
Okay.
Because after school, for some time, when I went to university, I dropped my guitar for some time. And there was this friend of mine that was always encouraging, like, hey, what happened to your guitar? And I had this relationship, open relationship then, so I forgot my guitar. So then, he told me to, because I picked up the guitar again and started learning. And one day, I came to Mubiwa. There's this guy that's only telling me about, what's that place called again?
Freedom.
So the island.
Freedom.
Yeah, Freedom Hall. So this, my friend, we met online, he's only telling me about Freedom Hall. So he said I could go and perform. But luckily I'm a guitarist, so that day I went with my guitar, but I could not perform and I felt bad. So I was on my way home and I met Mujuba, and he was like, do you play the guitar? Oh, that's nice. He gave me his cards, and that was how we started talking. And then he said I could come to his place. From his place, I met a guy that introduced me to Alliance Francaise. So this particular day, I was just at home. I was actually playing the guitar. It was in September during the holiday. I was just playing the guitar. You know, by the way, time, he just called me, can you come to Orleans and say, there's a send-off party, and I'm always ready. I'm the type that always likes to go out to him. So I went with my guitar, and it was a send-off party. The other musicians were there, that had grown far. So I went with my guitar, and I played this Jeongoku, it's a remix of the last song. So I did it in my own version. I came with that was rock. I did the rock version of it. And I did aeroplane, it's a song in my name. And, you know, the director of Alliance Francaise was like, wow, you play really well. You know, she hugged me and she was all over me and all of that. I'm saying what led to my major. And you know, and normally when you go to a dance band set, they take some time before they consider you for a show. They have this monthly unplugged show that they do. But then she was all over me. She really liked me. They're like, okay, can you come for this and that? Like, well, I haven't really done much. I was in outing, like maybe wedding or another band then. But we haven't really done the secular big stuff. So November, to be precise, they called me and I got a call from this other guy that works at the New Fancy Center and had to like and called their blood on November 29th, to be precise. And like, are you kidding me? Like, yes. I'm like, yes, I can. Of course, why not? I can. I was so happy. So this day came and went. So Bogobiri was celebrating the 1 year anniversary with Alliance Francaise in partnership, and it was Bogobiri Festival. So it was two events in one. Oh my God, I was so nervous. I was so nervous. And I saw this white guy, the French guy. Hey, oh my God, I was so nervous. That was my first major, you know, secular show that people were there. I mean, a lot of people came out. And you know, that day, when I was told to give the appreciation, I was crying because I'm like, what? A lot of people came for me. You know, it was amazing. At first when I wanted to begin the show, I was tensed. You know, I was tensed because you know, a lot of people were already on the ground and everybody's treating me like a queen. And oh, you know, I was really tensed. I was tensed, but it was nice after that. It was very nice.
Have you traveled before?
Yes, I've been
what
to
Ghana. What was your experience? Tell us experience. The difference between Ghana and Nigeria.
The difference between Ghana and Nigeria. Why did I even travel to Ghana? I traveled to Ghana because it's very funny. I went to the American embassy and I was denied. I'm like, what the fuck? Okay, I'm going to travel anyways because I'm not kind of person. When I make up my mind to do something, I just have to do it. So I said, okay, I'm not going to America, I'm going to Ghana. So I have a friend online on Facebook. You know, social media is very beautiful, actually. And he plays the saxophone. He's like, okay, I'll be coming to Ghana next week. I'm like, are you serious? Not next month, not 2 months. I said, no, next week. I mean, now first, and next week. I just brought my guitar and traveled to Ghana. It was nice because I went by road, which was really, really nice. So he introduced me to quite a number of places where I could perform. We went to Jazz 233. I'm not making a mistake. We went there and a couple of places where he played, where they sell pizzas. So we went there, it was really nice. I played, I played the guitar. The love was massive. And one thing about Ghana that's different from Nigeria is they appreciate artists. They really appreciate artists, even with the fact that they didn't know I was coming because I just, my friend played there, I just went with my friend and they still even gave us, you know, gave something like, oh, no, they're singing, and oh, you know, they just started dropping money on the chair, and I was feeling like some kind of done. So, I mean, that's a lot of difference from, you know, Nigeria. When you play here, yeah, I do have my audience, but then some places, not just in Korea, you know, playing and stuff like this, easy talking away, but over there, it's different. It's so different. They appreciate you, and I like it. The first question I want to ask myself is if I have a role model. Because you know, when you hear people's stories, and sometimes when you see the way people act towards one another, and let's say that, okay, I'll share an experience. There's this person I've always liked from afar, and there's a particular time a friend of mine did copy of this person's song and then went to drop it. The way the treatment she got was, you know. So from that day, I said to myself that, look, all these people will call her own day. You get, everybody have their own attitude, they have their own weakness and all. So what's the point? Christ is my role model. I do whatever my Bible tells me to do. I'm not a pastor believing person. This way, my pastor says, I do what my Bible tells me to do. And probably some books that I read a lot, and this way I get my inspiration. That's it. For Nigerian artists, I like Olamide. He's always on the street, he's speaking his mind all the time. I love Basha, of course. I love Basha. Honestly.
Okay.
I like BMW Jeep.
Okay.
You know why I like it? I like it because Okay, it's funny. I don't think I can speak on camera. I like it because there was a guy I once dated, and then you know, as a young girl, you just want to help. You just want to help. Unless I don't know. I know. I'm sure that it wasn't a wrong impression. You know, sometimes as a lady, you're dating this guy. You want to help him. You want to support him to make it at all points, and then you give him all your best. So at some point, this guy wanted to get a car, and I used my school fee. Stupid, yes, but there's nothing left can I do.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, you know, I'm somebody that does business anyways. I feel like, okay, I can always be placing. So I gave it to him, we joined the money together, and then we got this car. We got a BMW, but not a Jeep. You get that I saved up, you know, to get for him. And since then, I've always been like, I will get a BMW, a Jeep to be precise, this time around. So I can show this guy. Sure, I can show this guy, but I really like a BMW. Anyways, as I start, because it's quite strong.
Yeah.
Okay.
Your parents, your mom?
My dad is a pastor. The pastor's a church, and of course, when your dad is a pastor, your mom is also a pastor, apparently. And my mom owns a school. And my mom is generally called mother of all, because while we were growing up, we had a number of us. Like, not because we were many, we were just three. She had just three of us, but my mom is someone that likes kids. Like, either she knows your family or not, you are always welcome. So then we had kids. It's not even kids. While we were growing up, we had quite a number of us, you know. And in fact, then I could almost not differentiate if she was my mom or you know whose mom she was. So I felt like maybe we're just here, sure. Because there's one other auntie that takes care of her. My family is a nice family. So my dad is a very principled person. I remember him fighting me over fighting guitar. You know, choosing a music career. But overall, they're nice, awesome.
Now, to the younger generation who needs. Who sees you as their role model?
Okay, my advice is do not give up. You know, don't give up and believe in yourself. Very, very important. Believe in yourself. This is what I tell everybody every day. Believe in yourself. You know, there's this message someone sent to me of recent. I met her at an audition, this Nigerian Idol audition, and since then because she was not selected, you know, she gave up on herself and she stopped doing music, apparently. So I reached out to her, I'm like, what's happening? You know, have you been? And what's up with you? And because I knew this lady can sing. From what I saw that day, you know, she sang to her. So I took my time to encourage her and tell her, look here, don't let anyone deceive you. You are good. And the number one fan you need is yourself. If you can believe in yourself, then every other person will believe in you. And that's what I want everybody to go, to wake up with every morning, that I believe in myself. I am good. I am good. I am the best of myself. I am the best. I am the best the God has given me. Okay, I'm a very successful. I'm single and happy.
You're not shy.
I'm single and happy. I can't do the one to do the search. I'm sure that someone will search.